hope we can meditate as we are in this darkness, but we can meditate in our heart. So this time we want to look at the book of Romans, chapter 2. We want to look at from the last time about the sin. Actually, this part, the book of Romans, chapter 2, is talking about the sin. So last time, the Romans chapter 1 was talking about the sin of the non-believers. They don't want to believe in God, even though they know there is God, but they don't want to believe in God. Here then, chapter 2 is talking about another kind of sin, which is done by the believers. So if we are saying that I'm not a Jew, because this chapter is the sin of the Jew, so I'm not a Jew, so this word is not for me. Then the Jewish people at that time, it represents the believers of God. So nowadays, who are the believers of God? It is us. So we need to apply the Bible to our life. So maybe because Apostle Paul was talking to the Gentiles that you are a sinner because you don't believe in God, then maybe the Jewish people will be so happy. That's true. The non-believers, they are the sinners. Then suddenly Apostle was saying to the Jews, do you think you are okay then? You are righteous? So his direction was now on the believers. So we can read it as our teaching, the teaching to us. So if we are reading some verses about the sin, then it's not easy when we are hard and this kind of like rebuking, then we are not feeling very comfortable, but then I hope this can be also good medicine for us so that we can be cleansed as we are listening and as we are applying it to us, we can know about the righteousness and then we can change. So the chapter 2 was talking about that if you know what is sin, but if you do the sin, then this is more ugly sin, this is more evil sin. So the Jews, the believers, you know the law very well, isn't it? But then also, you are doing the sin again and again, isn't it? Then this is so evil, much more evil than the non-believers who don't know what is the sin and do it. So why Apostle Paul was talking about this is the Jewish people at that time, they were thinking that they are really favored by God, especially. They are different from the non-believers. God loves them more. So they will not be judged by God because they are already chosen. Maybe we are also thinking that because God loves me, I'm saved. Then God's wrath, God's anger will not be upon me. It's not about my story. It is about the non-believers. They need to be saved, but then I'm okay. This kind of thinking, if we have, then we also need to listen to this message. Are we not the people who are under the wrath of God, really? God will not be angry with us. It's not. So the Jewish people was thinking, they were thinking that the Gentiles, they are born to be punished by God. Whatever they do, they will be used as the stick of the hell. They will be burnt. So we should not associate with them. And then, especially the maybe the Gentile women, we don't need to help them. Even though they are sick, we don't need to heal them, because the women, they will give birth to the newborn babies. And then the Gentiles, they will just be punished. So the women shouldn't maybe give birth to other Gentiles. So they did not help them at all. Then the Jewish people, they did not associate with the Gentiles. They were thinking, Gentiles, we should be far away from them. They were feeling that the Gentiles are like very ugly insects, or like with very dirty things. So if we are close to them, then we will be affected. So we should not be with them. They are just sinners. So how can I associate with them, those people, as I'm the righteous, I'm the God's people, I am the person of God. So if we have this kind of thinking that the sinners in this world, I'm different from them, and then I should not talk with them, I should not associate with them, then this is not the teaching of Jesus. Jesus said that you should go to the end of the earth. You should associate with them. You should be the light and salt in this world. Okay, so let us read verse 1 to 3. It says that, and version is ESV. Therefore, you have no excuse, O man, every one of you who judges. For in passing judgment on another, you condemn yourself, because you, the judge, practice the very same things. We know that the judgment of God rightly falls on those who practice such things. Do you suppose, O man, you who judge those who practice such things and yet do them yourself, that you will escape the judgment of God? So what is the sin of the Jews? It is judgment, passing judgment on another. So Jesus also said that you should not judge other people. In Matthew chapter 7, so let us read in Matthew chapter 7, verse 1 to 2. Matthew chapter 7, it says that, judge not, that you be not judged. For with the judgment you pronounce, you will be judged. And with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, let me take the speck out of your eye, when there is the log in your own eye? You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take the speck out of your brother's eye. So here then, Jesus said, do not judge at all. But then, we are somehow easily criticize others and judge others with our own standard. But then we need to know, one day also we will be judged with the same thing, because we are not perfect. we are also doing the sins, the same sins. So Jesus said that do not judge easily. Why? Because when we judge, then normally our heart is not loving the person. It's not with the loving heart we are saying the judging words. So our heart is the problem. When we are judging, then that heart of hatred can be the problem. So if we are hating others, it is the mother. So that sin, if we have, then we are also the great sinners. So if we are judging without the love, then our sin is bigger. And the Bible is saying that if you are hating others, then you are the mother. So if you have that sin inside of you, and then you are now trying to judge others, then you have more sin, then you cannot be the judge. So, with that heart, without the love, then if we just judge others, then we cannot change other people as we want. But then what does the Bible says? God is righteous judge. God is fair, very fair. God's judgment is very fair, and then it doesn't have any favoritism. Then, so if we go back to the book of Romans chapter 2, then, God will be the same way God will judge us. Verse 2, we know that the judgment of God rightly falls on those who practice such things. God's judgment is very, very fair, so it will come to you. So we need to be, we need to fear. And God's love is the same to all the people. To the righteous and to the sinners, God loves us. So no one is closer to God, no one is farther to God. When we are praying, the people on the street, the people outside, and the people inside of the church, God will listen, both of them. So we should not easily judge other people, not knowing their heart. So we can be easily thinking that I'm more favored by God. We are easily feeling like that. But then we need to know God loves all of them, all of us. So if we say about the love, and then if we are also thinking that I'm more favored from God, then this is not the love. God's love is very fair and to all of them. But if we are saying that God loves you, but if we are thinking that I love more and other people should be judged more than me, then this is very ugly thinking. So we need to know we are all receiving the same love, and also we will be judged the same way. So that was the problem of the Jewish people who are thinking that they are chosen by God. But then God taught them when the time of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit was poured to all the people who are gathered there, maybe all the women, even all the male or female servants, there was no discrimination. So God's love was all the same to all the people. But then the Jewish people, they were thinking that they are different from the Gentiles. Because of their thinking, long times of thinking, I'm the chosen by God, and I'm the descendant of Abraham. I'm different. And then even though they become Christian, still they were thinking like that. The Gentiles are different. They should become the Jew so that they can be saved. That's what they were putting in their mind, that the Gentiles should be Jew, become the Jew first, and then they can believe in Jesus. So they were insisting about, insisting the circumcision of the Gentiles. They should also circumcise so that they can become the Jew, then they will be saved through Jesus Christ. But then there was no about this kind of discrimination of like with outer things, right? So like God loves me is very, very clear, but then maybe it is not for other people. It is not for Gentiles. It is not for the non-believers. That kind of thinking is what we can also easily feel. But we need to know all the people are the same before God. So verse 4, let us read. Or do you presume on the riches of his kindness and forbearance and patience, not knowing that God's kindness is meant to lead you to repentance? So, do you despise the love of God, you know, the kindness and forbearance? What is it? It is forgiveness of God. Even though you sin, but then God forgive you. This love, forgiveness and love. Do you despise this forgiveness and the love of God? If we are forgiven, but then if we also do the same, if we don't forgive other people, and if we don't have love, then this is like we are despising the forgiveness of God or the love of God. Even though we are in the love of God, but then if we don't love, then it is you are making it small or making despising this love. And then also you don't repent. Even though you have sinned, but then you receive the forgiveness, but then you don't just really repent. You know, true repentance is when we repent, when we realize the sin against God, and then if we repent, then we should not repeat it again and again. You know? But the inside of the believers, they are thinking that God is forgiving. God is God who is forgiving. So last time also he forgave. His love, he continually forgiving me. You know, Jesus said that forgive 70 times 7, you know, continually. Then God is forgiving me like that. He did not punish me. So even if I do the sin again, it will be okay. Because God is merciful, then this sin, it will be okay. So we just do it again, thinking that God's forgiveness is just there. So we are easily receiving this forgiveness and do the same sin again. So this is, we are like despising the love of God. We don't think it's very precious. Because, you know, but then we don't really experience the judgment or punishment, then we feel that it is just easy. But then there is the judgment. Fair judgment is there. One day if we continue, continually doing this sin, one day it will collapse. God's the day of judgment will come to you suddenly. So we should not have this kind of thinking that I can repeat. Because God is righteous, God's judgment will be there. Even though God's judgment is not now, but we should not think it easy. Even though God is not like beating me every time when I sin, but then there is the result of the sin, and our sin is stored up. So God knows all our heart. What kind of sin we did, God knows. God knows everything. But then still, God is waiting for us to repent truly. So we should have the fear about this punishment or judgment of God. So when we don't have the fear about this judgment of God, then it is crisis of our faith. So let us read 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 3. Second Peter chapter 3, verse 3. It says, knowing this first of all, that scoffers will come in the last days with scoffing, following their own sinful desires. They will say, where is the promise of his coming? For ever since the fathers fell asleep, all things are continuing as they were from the beginning of creation. So they deliberately overlook this fact that the heavens existed long ago, and the earth was formed out of water and through water by the word of God. And then by means of this, the world then existed was deluged with water and perished. So people are saying, where is God? Where is the promise of God? It is the same. The world doesn't have any sign about God's coming. So last days, people were scoffing, and then they say that there is no God. But then it looked to be God is slow to come to us. So let us read verse 8. But do not overlook this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord, one day is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as one day. The Lord is not slow to fulfill his promise, as some count slowness, but is patient toward you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should reach repentance. So, the why God does not punish us? Why the promise of God is not coming now? God will judge us, but then why he is not judging now? It's not that God is very slow, but God is waiting patiently that everyone can come back to God, repenting their sins. So, if the people who receive the love of God, if they are continually repeating the sins, knowing the love of God, knowing the forgiveness of God, then this is more holy sins. We should come back to God, repenting our sins quickly, and then we should not repeat again. So, we need to repent our sins, and that we should run away from these sins. We need to repent. If we repent, then fully we should repent and change our lives as soon as possible. We cannot deceive God. Then we should not despise the forgiveness of God. So when we realize the love of God, then we should not despise it. Yeah, so let us go back to the book of Romans, chapter 2. Verse 5. But because of your hard and impenitent heart, you are storing up wrath for yourself on the day of wrath, when God's righteous judgment will be revealed. So it says that your hard and impenitent heart. So you are very stubborn. You don't repent. You have a hard heart. Even though you are living under this grace, under this merciful hand of God, but then you don't repent and you don't change your life. And then you just look at the sin of other people. Then this is ugly. You need to look at yourself and you need to realize you are a sinner. But then the word of God means to us to change myself, actually. When we read the word of God, we should not use it to attack other people. The Bible is saying that this is sin. But this person is against that sin, against this law. If we are judging others with the law, not to us, but others, then this is very, very evil. It is very ugly sin. So we need to look at ourselves within the Word of God. We need to look at, we can check ourselves whether we have the sin or not, not other people. That is what Jesus said, do not judge others. So, but then we have that stubbornness. We know what is the problem of ourselves, what is the sin of us. But then we don't change. This is hardened heart or stubborn heart. So thinking that God is love, God was just quiet, even though I lived like this way. If we are thinking like that, then we are very danger in our faith. So so for the sin, as we know, then let us look at ourselves. If we have any sin, then think it seriously and try to change it with all our effort. That is what we should do. Because we are the people who are receiving the love of God, and then if we are thinking that my sin is just small, it will be okay. Then it will give a lot of pain to God. So let us go to verse 6. He will render to each one according to his works. So God will pay. God will render to each one according to his works. How you lived, you will be judged. So you will be judged by the fruit. How you lived, you will receive. So we need to know this one, this word, this truth. So verse 7 to 11. To those who by patience in well-doing seek for glory and honor and immortality, he will give eternal life. But for those who are sick and self-seeking and do not obey the truth, but obey unrighteousness, there will be wrath and fury. There will be tribulation and distress for every human being who does evil, the Jew first and also the Greek. But glory and honor and peace for everyone who does good, the Jew first and also the Greek, for God shows no partiality. So here, Jew is the believer and Greek is non-believer. So according to how you lived, if you are seeking the glory and honor of God, then you will receive the reward. You will also receive the glory. But then if you are seeking, if you are living selfish and self-desire, following the self-desire, sinful desire, then there will be God's anger. So there is no partiality, no discrimination in God. God will look at your life, and then God will judge fairly. So we need to know God is God of judgment. We should not just think that God is God of law only. We need to have this balanced faith. God will judge us. So, if we live without the judgment of God, but if we receive the great mercy and grace of God, we need to know that this is the time for us to stand well. God is merciful, so God is giving us the chance to change our life. So God is not looking at the outer things. So God is not judging us according to outer things. What is the outer things? Outer things are like whether we are Christian, whether we are coming to church every day, whether we are serving something in the church. It doesn't matter, actually. It doesn't matter that God will have more favor to our lives. God will judge us according to how I live. So we should be humble, and we need to know we are the same. We are sinners. We are the same people like other people. So we are only living because of the grace of God. We are receiving the grace. So we need to give thanks to God for this. Then we should not be boasting ourselves because of my life of faith and my serving God. We are not different, not so different. Not by out of the things God will judge us, and we will be judged by our life. So this time, as we meditate the sins of the believers, I hope we can meditate it deeply, and then we don't fall into the sin which the Jews had. Then we can be the people who are loved by God through our lives. So let us pray together. Our Heavenly Father, this time we give thanks to you for your precious word, Lord. We thank you for your grace upon the sinners. We could know how merciful you are as you forgave our sins. But then we want to look at ourselves and we want to repent our sins. We have sins which we did not really change and repent in. Lord, please help us to repent and change our lives. and we want to have also the fairness toward others. We don't want to be the judge, but we want to help other people to come back to God by our heart of love. God, please help us to live with this heart, so that our life can be pleasing in you, and we can receive the great reward and the honor and glory from you. Lord, we thank you for this time, and I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.